Hey guys! Today I thought it'd be really fun to do a video that's not just me sitting at my desk and like putting on makeup, although that fun. I thought it'd be kind of cool to do more where I'm kind of like vibing with you, talking to you more, showing you some stuff. So today I wanted to do a beauty filming room tour, beauty organization, I guess you could say. This is my beauty room and my filming room. I've never showed you guys this and I've been here for like quite a bit and I just redid it because I wanted to get back into filming videos. I am really, really excited about it. I'm really happy with how it turned out and little preface, this is going to be a real tour. I'm not making anything look better than it is. Let me show you some B-roll that I took because I'm very proud of that. So that's just a little sneak peek of what it looks like and like, right? It's like pretty nice. Well, oh, well, you thought. Nice, organized, airy. Let me give you the real deal really quick. So, we see, look at this. This is a freaking maze. I mean, obviously, still really, really proud of everything, but yeah. Yeah, it's a bit of a jungle gym. I feel like sometimes there is a aura to a YouTube beauty room or just a filming room or whatever where it's supposed to be nice and tidy, but to be honest, when you're filming and having to move around stuff and like use a bunch of makeup products, it gets kind of crazy. So let's get started. Let me just take you around the room, show you what it is because yeah. Why not? Let's do it. I could be in a lunge this whole video because the camera only goes so far. But I wanted to show you guys the side of the room that you never see. So I don't really know the size of this room, but it's a pretty decent size. This was originally supposed to be the bedroom and then I just used it for the filming room. But this is the side that is not decorated. Cameras obviously like face that way, so you never see here. I have a really nice mirror here that I didn't clean. I swear I cleaned every part of this and I just remembered I didn't clean that. I wish I had like a better place to put it, but I wanted to use it to kind of take some full length alpha pictures. So for right now, it's there so I can move it around. And the worst part of the room is like right there. Just the router and everything. The reason I call it the worst part of the room is because I keep forgetting to dust it whenever we don't need internet or cable or anything because what's gonna happen if I sweep and take the dust off of it is that it'll probably detach a wire. So there just never seems to be a good time when I'm like, I don't need any computer, I don't need any TV because it takes like 15 minutes to restart and I know that's not even that long a time, but it's long enough to keep me from ever dusting that area. So don't work too hard at that area. And then I just have my printer, some paperwork and books. And you guys remember this? Remember when I did beauty guru cocktails? It's dusty too, but this was the Kylie one. It still exists. Now let me take you over here. That is the outdoors, guys. I get like 40% light. You see me sweating? This is a workout. See what I'm doing right now? Oh, you can't even get down there. I'm doing a plie. So when I don't have my ring light or my softbox is on, I like to open this a little to get some sunlight in, obviously. But the problem is the sun doesn't come in here. I don't know how to explain exactly why, but yeah, the sun never shines in here. We get like the byproduct of sun. It's still something, but it's very dark. So I can't really ever use natural sunlight to take pictures in my room, but just gotta go outside. So I'm hoping that this is now obvious that this is a more like a vlog style type of video rather than a very elegantly like put together. I wanted to do kind of more chill videos, just an FYI, but continuing on. This was the door. I don't think I showed you that, but now we're gonna come over to the meat and potatoes of the room. This is where all the magic happens, guys. Let's start off with my desk. This is my desk. I have my big Mac guy right there. The keyboard broke, so now I have this random keyboard, which is pretty nice. I like the sleekness of the Mac ones, though. But I still have the trackpad. This always looks funny. I have this really nice mirror. I actually love this mirror. Again, not cleaned, my goodness. It's one of those where you can like turn it on and the light comes on. Like that. It's pretty cool. The reason why it's sitting on hair gel, I use a hair gel for my eyebrows and I can't see myself in the mirror unless it's like propped up on something. And then I sneeze a lot, so we toilet paper. Moving on, this is like the coolest light. It adds a lot of warmth to my videos, so I absolutely love having that there. And then I just have random stuff in here. I absolutely love long chargers. Do you see how long this charger is? Like I don't even know if you can grasp the gravity of how long this is, But I like that because I just get annoyed if I pull on it and it comes off. So we've eliminated that problem by having a 10-foot cord. This is just for all my necessities and it looks absolutely gross just because it doesn't match any of the colors. I have to fix that and get something else. But for right now, that's what it is. You can see like everything in it. That's why it looks weird because there's no color coordination there. Then a new mini tripod that I just got. I love him. I also have a cute gray rug under there that absolutely collects anything that falls down there, including nail polish that I've accidentally dropped. So I don't recommend getting one of those. I mean, they look really cute. Maybe you guys have a tip for how to keep it clean. And I have a trash can, which is way too small, but I think it looks cute. Chair that is absolutely broken, but you know, you don't see my chair when I film, so we're just gonna keep that. And I just got a new desk a little bit ago. Look how cool this is. It's a rising and lowering desk. So I push a button and it goes up and down so I can stand at it if I want to. Not that I really do that much, but it's pretty cool. Moving on to this corner of the room. This area I'm so, so happy with. It turned out so good. So I replaced the lipsticks and lip glosses with like newer ones so that I would be able to find them easier. Cause you know, when you're doing videos and Instagram videos and that kind of thing, you wanna use the newest stuff first cause people are like curious about them. So I put them up there to remind myself which ones are the newer, and I feel like it looks really good. Two plastic things. They're just from Michaels and I redid everything. Things are a lot more spread out. I can reach them. That was the problem with the last ones. I was piling them too high and then I couldn't find anything inside of them. I did like the top things. Oh, if you guys saw what it looked like before, it looks so much better now. If you saw my vlog, I kind of showed you guys what this area looked like. You've made some really, really good progress. So we have my happy hour sign, had to keep that. And then these two things, I absolutely love. They look so good. Show you guys a couple drawers. These are sprays. These are lip glosses, lipsticks. This is my, well, other than this thing, this is hair stuff that I use right now. These are future videos, so I'm really excited. I figured I'd put them in one place. I have my skincare. I really wish I had a better way to put them, but that's just how it is right now. That's just nail stuff, and then the bottom is tech. Hair and sunglasses, jewelry, more skincare, more skincare. Here are palettes and more hair stuff. So now from this beautiful organization that makes me feel so good to look at, we have down here. So these are the misfits that I really had no idea where to put. Just stuff that I am making a video on very soon, or PR that I just got that I want to like keep it in this little package to put in a video, and then some tech stuff that I use all the time. So different tripods, I have a macro lens in there, and then this is an iPhone clip. So I didn't know where to put these. There is no more closet room in this apartment, so I'm right here for right now until I figure out what to do with them. If I film with this stuff, then I can move it. So I guess that's incentive. And then right here, I actually thought this looked cute. This is a couple more PR things that I didn't want to take out of their stuff because I think it would be really cute in a video to keep it in there. And look at this, this is so cute. This was from Pixie. It says my name on it. It's so cool, it's like a tote bag. I'll have to show you guys that in an Insta video. That's what it's there for, so I remember. And then while you're here, I wanted to show you guys my e.l.f. packaging. They sent me a couple of the new stuff on their website and was like really excited. So also the boxes, no one's getting in here. There is so many layers to open this. I'll show you the four things that I got really quick. Also, they sent me hand sanitizer. How cool is that? That's so sweet. So I got the liquid glitter eyeshadow, and this is like a green color, and oh my gosh, it is so freaking nice. It really reminds me of the Stila ones. Really inexpensive too. Really pretty, like mermaid green color. Look how nice that is. It goes on so well. I was really surprised that it wasn't like patchy or anything. Other thing that I picked out because I thought it was really cool, they let me pick out a couple products. Bite-sized face duo in white peach. So this is so tiny and cute. Like, this is perfect for like taking on the go and travel. This peach color, which you guys know is my favorite color for blushes, is super subtle peach, so you don't have to worry about getting like a really orange cheek if that's not what you're trying for. And then the highlighter is really nice. And then the last two items just go hand in hand. This is what I was most excited to try. This is the e.l.f. multi-dimensional face and body shimmer, and it is the white one. This is part of their Retro Paradise collection. And then also the e.l.f. glow up body brush. It is the softest brush ever. Obviously it's really, really nice with this. I'll show you this in a second, but the brush in general would be so good for any kind of shimmer that you have, and you can just quickly put it all over your body, so that's really nice. It's definitely eye-catching in the sun, but it's not chunky glitters, because that's definitely a different vibe. I'd be doing that at like a festival, or if I go to a club, I want like chunkier glitter, but just for a nice like kind of glow, this is so nice. It's gonna be impossible to show you in this lighting right now, but I can show you a close-up that I took to show you like just how cute it is. It's just small little glitters. It's so nice, and I could just play with this brush all day. If you guys want to check out any of these, there'll be a link down below if you want to. And let's move on. Now, guys, this is the Coup de la Grâce. Coup de grâce.
Coup de grace.
Yes, I insist on saying sayings that I'm not quite sure what they are. I was impressed with myself. It definitely is something that 10-year-olds do, but I am really bad at interior design or even just decorating, I guess you would say. So when I did this, I amazed myself. So I'm hoping you guys like it too. Some of y'all have seen this on Instagram stories already, but let me take you to the best area of my room, which is right behind where the camera will be showing. That's why the effort went there. Look at that. Okay, I get it. I get it that it's just fairy lights, but I just love how it swoops and then goes around the sunflower. I absolutely love that because then right here, I can stand for outfit videos. I'll have the camera on the other end of the room near the router and you'll be able to see my full outfit and you'll have at least this behind to kind of look cool because I was like, I don't know what backdrop to use. I can't really move this like big table around too much. It's kind of heavy. Oh, I couldn't just stand in front of my makeup background. So I thought that was the perfect solution. And I really do think it looks good. I haven't filmed with it yet, but I'm really excited. Oh my gosh, I almost forgot to show you the best part. Kind of looks better blurry. Ooh, there's a lot of freaking settings on here. I don't know what they all do. I can do, not that I would ever do that. I think that would give us all a headache. I can do smooth. Kind of nice, even blurry. Moving over, you'll see some old favorites. This is like the filming area that you're gonna see behind my head when I'm filming just sit down makeup videos. So I still have my two drawers. This one's from Michaels. I get asked a lot about that one. And then that one's from IKEA, which I get asked a lot about too, but that one's kind of iconic. So I think more of you guys know about the Alex 9 drawer, but this one is like $40 from Michaels, I think. And it's really cute. It's not the most stable. It kind of leans against that, but that's because I have it stocked full of so much makeup, but hey, it works. Another thing that I think is kind of genius, like I'm sure it's been done before, but I swear I didn't get this idea from anybody else. I had nowhere to put my jewelry. I can't drill holes in the apartment, so I couldn't do like a nice like hanging board or anything, and I didn't want another big piece of furniture. So instead, on here, I secured them and now they're hanging here. So I can see all of them and I can put them on that way. So I don't have to like root through like a bag. I have some jewelry in that drawer that you see, but it is a show in there, try and get anything out. So all my good stuff that I like is right here, and then some of it's actually attached. You can tell right here, but I may do with what you got. So then I have my CVS pineapple, which I'm so excited about, that still works. I love green plants, but I don't know how to take care of real ones and I don't want to kill them, so everything is fake. Then this is a little, I don't know if you guys ever had this, but it was a makeup palette that came in that. It was, you would pull it out and there's like eyeshadows and stuff, but once you were done with the makeup, you could take it out and just use this as, I guess, the jewelry box is what I'm using it for, but you could use it for anything. So it just has a little bit more jewelry in there.
Just a little bit of somethings in here. I have a lot of odds and ends. Closer up of that guy and little baby guy. I don't remember where I got him. There's my graveyard girl glass that I painted. And in here, I just have the newest stuff that I want to do something with. This is other new stuff that I want to do something with. This is concealers, blushes, bronzers, blushes, more concealers, and more blushes. These are like highlighters of all kinds. They have like solids, gels, that kind of stuff. Eyeliners. Palettes. You know, I'm not really sure what this guy was. I guess I didn't finish. More palettes. And finally, lip products. We have like lip liners, lipsticks, that kind of thing. And then my Alex 9. I love these lights. Those are mad cute. They're tiny pineapples. And then the little cart is from a CVS content thing that I did. And they had given me a free little cart to create content with. So now it's just there. Paperwork and stuff. This is a shell my friend gave me and I'm using it to put my lashes in. My best lashes, like the ones I use all the time. And then my watch. These are the brushes I use all the time. Then we have eyelashes, my calculator. It's kind of a little bit more random. I have like a notepad in there, but just like lashes supposed to be in there. A little bit of lashes back there that are specialty lashes, and then tools, face stuff, foundations, eyebrows, concealers, powders, more foundations. Then we have eye stuff, mascara, liquid eyeshadow, regular eyeshadow, lip stuff, kind of random chapstick, some liquid lipsticks. And then we don't go in that drawer. That drawer is full of so many brushes that I haven't gone through. And finally, this little corner right here, gotta move him back. I have this little fake palm that I absolutely love. I just got this from Amazon and it's just my calendar of stuff. And then I got these micro pens, which I have not used yet actually, but I'm really excited to try those because this one was just a little too thick. I didn't like that as much, but got a couple colors.
colors, so I'm really excited. I can't hang it up though, like I said. It's a little too heavy for command strips, but it's cute. And these guys that I've had forever, and I just love them.
So I hope you guys liked seeing my beauty and filming room. I hope it wasn't too annoying for you that I'm like so sweaty. I need to figure out a way to not have this place go up to like 85 degrees, but you still be able to hear me, because if I turn the fan on,
standing in front of these. It's toasty.
I hope you enjoyed this. Definitely leave me a thumbs up if you like this new content that I'm doing, so I know that you guys like it. I'm having a lot of fun trying out new stuff, so I hope it's fun for you too, and we can only get better from here. I'm trying to not be a perfectionist about stuff, and I know I'm gonna have a lot of issues with this footage, but we're trying, you know? We just have to jump off and do it. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.